Thanks for the introduction, and thanks to the organizing committee and in particular to Alejandro for this invitation. It's a pleasure for me to be here. I think that I will do my presentation from here because I don't want to have any international conflict with these flags.
Okay.
Okay. Yes, I have the computer here. Well, today I will tell you about some computational solutions that we are working in the area of inference and modeling of gene regulatory networks, but biological networks using gene expression data. This is an overview of my presentation. I will start presenting our lab and our motivations. Then I will discuss some topics related with network modeling using gene expression data. And then I will make a brief introduction to some of the methods and tools that we are developing. My idea is don't go very deep in the algorithmic details behind each of the methods. I would like give a big picture about what you can do with the tools, and I will indicate in each tool the corresponding reference to the publication for more detail. Well, the name of our lab is BioChemTICS, and is part of the Instituto de Ciencias e Ingeniería de la Computación, which belongs to CONICET, Universidad Nacional del Sur. It's located in Bahía Blanca, in the south of the Buenos Aires province. And our main goal is try to define new algorithms, new methodologies for predictive modeling in some topics in the area of system biology and molecular informatics. Our background is strong in computer science, and then our contributions are mostly focused in the computer science issues associated with the development of the methods, okay? And in particular, in biological network modeling, our approach are based in machine learning strategies, and are model-free and data-driven approaches. Well, the general idea of our approach is very simple. We use gene expression data matrix, and we apply different machine learning methods for pattern matching between the gene expression profiles. And from this pattern, we extract association rules, and from these association rules, we define the topology of the network. We say that our models are model-free because we don't have any assumption about the topology of the network. All the topology is derived from the association that we extract from pattern matching. Well, I suppose that most of you are familiarized with the machine learning approach and the steps associated with machine learning. For the case of meaning association rules, it's not different to most of the machine learning procedures. You have data, you split the data and save part of the data for testing. You use some of the data for training, you extract patterns, then you validate the association rules that you extract from the patterns, and then you need to make a biological curation of the data, and the final set of association rules that you obtain is used for defining the topology of the network. When you are working in particular mining association rules, you need to define the representation of the rules and the semantics, the syntaxis and the semantics of these rules. For example, here we have an annotation that says plus gene A implies plus gene B, and this could mean that when gene A is overexpressed, gene B will be also overexpressed. And you need to deal with several subproblems when you are defining a methodology for meaning association rules. In particular, in this presentation, I will focus in the discretization process, which is one of the pre-processing steps in this problem, because many of the contributions that we are doing in this area is associated with the discretization of gene expression data. Well, many algorithms in machine learning requires that the information of the data is expressed in terms of a finite number of states. For this reason, the methodology that you decide to use for discretization have a big impact in the results, because when you apply the machine learning method, you are working directly over the discretized data. Okay. During last decades, many methods was proposed for discretization of gene expression data with different proposals. A few years ago, we make a review about the state of art in these methodologies, and we develop a software tool where we implement several of the methods that are part of the state of art in discretization of gene expression data. But our work in the design of discretization alternative for inferring of gene regulatory networks started several years ago in collaboration with the Artificial Intelligence Research Lab at the University of Ulster in the UK. At that moment, many of the methods proposed for extracting association rules in the inference of gene regulatory networks define arbitrary discretization schemes, most of them based in the average value of the gene expression profiles. And in this method, we developed an algorithm based in combinatorial optimization, defining classifiers. But one of the most important features of this new method was a new adaptive scheme for discretization, where the idea is try to have a specific discretization per each pair of genes. The idea is that when you are considered a gene A as a potential regulator of a gene B, probably the threshold that you need for discretization in this relationship is not the same that you need when you are considering the same gene A as a potential regulator of another gene C. Then, with the adaptive mechanisms for discretization that we propose, based in partition and entropy metrics, we obtain good results. At that moment, one of the methods, state of art, was the method of Soinov and Bulaszewska for extracting association rules, and we obtain a very good performance in comparison with this method. After that, in the context of a PhD thesis in our lab, we developed an extension of this method. This extension incorporates several improvements. One of the improvements was associated with speed up the computations of the discretization thresholds, but we also extend in terms of semantics. One of the kind of rules that we incorporate were time-lagged rules, where you can detect patterns between the gene profiles that have some delay in the experiment. Of course, these kind of rules can be applied when you are working with time series. And more recently, in cooperation with the Intelligent Data Analysis Lab at the Universidad Pablo de Olavide in Seville, we are evaluating the extension of GRNN COP2 with functionalities related to semantic analysis of gene regulatory networks as a strategy for filter associations rules in large networks. In general, this kind of approach presents an explosion of associations in many cases, And the idea is try to use semantic analysis for filtering associations and also for improving the biological interpretability of the results. The first step in that direction was to develop a cytoscape app for the GRCOD2 in order to incorporate our method in the ecosystem of cytoscape. And now we are working in the incorporated of the semantic analysis. Another problem that we addressed in the area of gene expression analysis was the inference of biclustering, microarray biclustering. In this problem, we try to detect a subset of genes that synchronize his behavior only for some part of the samples that we have in experiments. And in general, when you are addressing this problem, you try to find the largest biclustering that don't exceed a certain level of similarity as a constraint, and where you need to have or you obtain a high root variance. You need a high root variance because you want to avoid the detection of a dummy B-cluster integrated only for genes that have an stable behavior, for example, silencing genes. Well, we worked in the design of several algorithms for microarray B-clustering. In particular, one of the methods, Vigea, achieved good performance in several scenarios. This method is based in evolutionary algorithms, which is an extension of genetic algorithms, and work as a multi-objective combinatorial optimization problems. And we hybridize this methodology with a local search technique, with the idea of speed up the convergence to the VSB clusters. Well, we also developed a tool for the B-clustering analysis of gene expression data with different kinds of visualizations. And then we work in the integration of GRCOD2 and Vigea in a new software tool that we call Schernet. The idea of this integration was try to use Vigea as a strategy for a local enrichment of the topology obtained by GRCOD2. And in this way, when you are working with a network and you identify a subset, a subnetwork in the analysis that is interesting to you, you can select this substructure in the network and you can apply the clustering analysis in order to detect another associations in this part of the network.